Good morning, everyone. This is Mia Bilasha, your favorite VRC mentor, and I'm back again with yet another episode of Mornings with the Hindu. So while we get started, I'm sure you can start liking the session and also sharing it within your groups. Remember to use Abhicat Live, guys. That's my referral code to unlock all free Unacademy courses and also to subscribe to Unacademy. Here are some of our iconic batches where you get a personal mentor, test analysis, OMET prep, and all the benefits of PLUS are included, guys. Here is our CAT 2020 result with my very own Piyush Pratik, and of course you could be next, guys. Using AbhiCAT will help you get in to this. Alright, new batches 9th June, 12th June and 16th June. Here are some new batches that are starting off, guys. Do make sure you're joining. Okay, bumper offer for CAT 21, 6 plus 1 is the offer. That means if you buy a 6-month subscription, you will get a 1-month subscription for free. And you will also get a 10% off on using AbhiCAT Live. So that's a lot of discount, guys. So our scholarship is available now and also live. So guys, if you wish to get a scholarship, all you have to do is very quickly enroll for it. Use my referral code for that, and you can use my referral code for that, or else you can scan this QR code and use. IBMAT BBN Hotel Management batches are live. So 19th of June is the comprehensive 1-year batch for IBMAT. Then you have IBMAT BBN HM bumper offer 12+2 and 24+3, and all. So you can get a 10% off if you use my referral code. Ask a Doubt is also live, guys. So you can ask as many doubts as you wish to. You're more than welcome to. Just click on Ask a Doubt, take a picture, send it to us. We'll resolve your doubts. All right, so here are some of my batches. The VRC Expert, the Legend batch, the Score Booster batch. Of course, amazing fun, guys. So today being Saturday, we've got two really amazing courses, the complete course on grammar at 5 p.m. and of course the course on critical reasoning basics for the weekend 7 to 8. These are two courses, guys, that are starting out, that have already started out, and we'll be doing classes for both of these today. So do join in. All right, let's get started. Terror in Sahel on growing Islamist violence in Africa. Excuse me. The massacre of at least 160 people in a border village in Burkina Faso over the weekend is a grim reminder of the threat the Sahel region faces from Islamist terrorism. Nobody has claimed responsibility, but Burkinabe authorities have named the Islamic State in the Greater Sahara, ISGS, which has carried out hundreds of terror strikes in recent years. The security situation in Burkina Faso, which saw its first major Islamist terrorist attack in 2015, has deteriorated steadily, especially along the borders with Niger and Mali. This has been the case with much of the Sahel region, a 5,900-kilometer-long semi-arid territory. It has seen terrorist groups expanding their networks and stepping up attacks on civilians and soldiers. The Burkina Faso attack occurred after 137 people were killed by jihadists in Niger in March. In Nigeria, Islamists control swaths of territories and have carried out abductions and attacks, including gunning down 27 people in a village on Sunday. Mali has been fighting terror groups since 2013. Four main terror outfits operate in the region: the ISGS, the Islamic State West Africa Province, ISWAP, the Jamaat Nasrul Islam Wal Muslimin, the local Al-Qaeda branch in Mali, and Boko Haram. Of these, the ISGS and Jamaat Nasr are reportedly in alliance to expand their influence in the Burkina, Mali, Niger broader region, where they shoot down anyone who does not declare their loyalty to the jihadist. Boko Haram and ISWAP are fighting each other but control territories in northern Nigeria. France has deployed troops in the region for counterinsurgency operations and is helped by the US, which has a drone base in Niger. The regime change policies of the US and France are partly to blame for the problems the Sahel countries are facing today. When a NATO invasion removed Muammar Gaddafi from power in Libya in 2011, the region lost a stable bulwark against militias and jihadists. Libya, having fallen into anarchy and civil war, became a jihadist breeding ground. When trouble spread to Mali, France made a military intervention in 2013, but it did not defeat the insurgency, which spread beyond Mali's borders. Now, jihadists fight safe havens in the lawless deserts of the Sahel. When the IS militant infrastructure was destroyed in Iraq and Syria, their foot soldiers fled to Africa, regrouping themselves in the region. The recent attack should serve as a warning to all stakeholders. Major global players, which work together with regional players to defeat the IS in West Asia, should not stay away from the growing threat from Africa. They should, along with the UN, help the Sahel countries build capacity and institutions, offer stable governance, and adopt sustainable counterinsurgency strategies. All right, so here's our first question of the day. Which of the following is the main idea of the passage? Islamic terror outfits in Africa are worrisome for everyone. There are many Islamic groups operating in Africa. Global powers should stay away from Islamic State, and ISIS and Boko Haram are functioning in Africa. Good morning, everyone. Hari Om, Gunja, Saraswati, Vishwajit, Riyaz, Sahil, Chinmay, Rishi, Ritesh, AJ, Razia, Shalini. Good morning, everyone. Nahi Saraswati, there is no rain that is happening in my area. Guys, have you liked the session? Not really. Please like the session, everyone. So I'm waiting for your answers, everyone. Yes, very good. Correct, everyone. A is the correct answer, that Islamic terror outfits in Africa are worrisome for everyone. It's not just the Africans who need to worry, it's the rest of the world also that really needs to be worried and concerned about this. There are many Islamic groups operating in Africa was not the main idea. C was something that was against the theme of the passage, and ISIS is not really functioning, it is ISGS, so that is the one that we are looking at. Boko Haram, of course, is working in Nigeria. Alright, here's your next question. So, four more terror outfits operate in Africa, the ISGS, the Islamic State West African Province, the Jamaat Nasr al-Islam wal Muslimin, and the local Al-Qaeda branch in Mali, and Boko Haram are the outfits. The ISGS and Jamaat Nasr are reportedly in alliance to expand their influence in the Burkina Mali-Niger border region. Boko Haram and ISWAP are fighting each other but control territories in northwestern Nigeria. Quickly, guys, let's get this show on the road. What is the correct answer? Sadly, AJ, people don't talk about these things. Correct? A is true, so therefore cannot be the answer. B is true, therefore cannot be the answer. C is true, therefore cannot be the answer. D is very correct, and that's the correct answer because it is not northwestern Nigeria, it is northeastern Nigeria. All right, here's your structure question of the day. Regime change policies of the US and France are partly to be blamed for the problems the Sahel countries are facing today, and B, the recent attack should serve as a warning to all stakeholders. Very quickly. Everybody, please like the session. Yes, Rahul, I wish we could do this, but the screen as it is would be very difficult to adjust both of the things. And my expectation is that you would have read this editorial yesterday. So the regime change policies of the US and France are partly to be blamed for the problems of the Sahel countries, and the recent attacks should serve as a warning. There is no relationship between the two, and therefore the correct answer is D, that they are unrelated. I go live at 9 a.m. every day, Rahul. What is the meaning of sustainable? Is it bearable? Is it intolerable? Is it cautious? Is it refulgent? I think a lot of you are going to get 515 today. Aisa lag raha hai mujhe. So of course, refulgent means very bright and shiny. So therefore, that cannot be the correct answer. Cautious, of course, is careful. Intolerable, of course, is something that cannot be tolerated. And therefore, bearable, which means something that can be tolerated, which can be continued, which can be done on a long term, is the correct answer. What is the meaning of safe havens? Is it to save someone? Is it a protected place? Is it dangerous? Is it a rebel group? I know, Saraswati. I have this intuition today. Lots of 515s. Yes, a safe haven. Haven is a place, right? A safe haven is a protected place. A place where you will not find any danger. Yes, that's the correct answer. Very good. All right, massacre. A mass killing is called a massacre. Grim reminder is a very sad reminder of something. Deteriorated is to worsen. Steadily is, of course, at a regular pace. I don't know why I've written steadily twice. Abduction, of course, is kidnapping. Gunning down, of course, means to kill. In alliance means to work together. Jihadists are those who fight a holy war, generally that's the correct answer, but of course in today's world they are terrorists, and they're Islamic terrorists. Deployed, of course, is to make use of something. Guys, I hope everybody has liked the session. Counterinsurgency, of course, is action against terrorists. Regime, of course, is rule. Bulwark is a protection or a protective wall. Anarchy is lawlessness. Breeding ground is place that is very fertile, right? So that intervention is interference. All right, that's all the words that are there for today, guys. Let me quickly see. A lot of 515s. Riyaz, Vishwajit, Gunjat, Chinmay, Sahil, Rishi, AJ, Saraswati, Hariom. Wonderful, you guys. Excellent. I had already predicted that you are all going to get 515 today. I think the questions were too easy, or maybe you guys are getting smarter. So that may be a possibility too, right? Okay, guys, so today is Saturday. So you already know we are going to be doing PJs at noon at 5 p.m. So schedule changes on the weekend. So at 5 p.m., we are going to be doing grammar, where we start with subject-verb agreement, and then we'll carry on with verbs if we have time. And then at 7 p.m., we are going to be doing CR. So we are doing logical fallacies today. I'm sure you're aware of this. So do make sure you're coming in for both the plus classes as per your schedule. And of course, come for the noon session. All right. Thank you, everybody. I will see you at noon and in the evening. Bye-bye. Adios, my amigos. Remember to like, share, subscribe and hit the bell icon. And also to use AbhiCat Live to unlock all Unacademy free courses and to subscribe to our Plus and Iconic courses.